lacrosse team comes out with a key ECAC victory over Fairfield in overtime with a final score of 7-6. The Stags were looking for their first victory over the Hounds since 2006, but sophomore Davis Butts was able to stop them, putting numbers on the board first with an assist from sophomore Mike Sawyer just a minute and a half into the game. Seconds later, Mike Sawyer catches a pass from Chris Palmer and gives the Hounds a 2-0 lead. With 11 seconds left in the first quarter, Fairfield's John Snellman scores with an assist from Max Trons. 5 minutes into the second quarter, Loyola senior Matt Langan gets a pass from Chris Basler and puts the Hounds up to a 3-1 lead. Just seconds later, Fairfield's Brent Adam responds quickly with a goal, trailing Loyola by one. With an extra man on in the third quarter, Fairfield's Matt Plaminski ties up the game 3-3 at 12 minutes and 19 seconds. Fairfield rushes down the field with 7 minutes left in the third and brings the Stags to a 4-3 lead over the Hounds.
You know, we come out with a 2-0 run, and you know they're going to score some goals, and we just had to answer back. You know, coming in the third quarter, they actually took a lead 4-3, and we had to put our foot down, and, you know, like Coach Timmy just said, getting a team 6 goals, we should win.
It's not long before the Hounds' Matt Langan grabs an assist from Mike Sawyer and makes his second shot of the day to tie the game 4-4 with only 4 minutes left in the third quarter. A minute later, senior DJ Comer scores unassisted, bringing the Hounds to a 5-4 lead over the Stags. 4 minutes into the fourth, Fairfield's Sam Snow ties up the game again, 5-5 with a goal. Fairfield senior Max Truns puts one past Jake Haglin with 4 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Loyola trails 6-5. Grad student Chris Palmer comes around the back of the crease to fire one past Fairfield Cipriano, tying the game 6-6 with just 2 minutes left to play. The Greyhounds prevent Fairfield from scoring as time winds down in regulation and sends the two teams into overtime. John Chivoni wins faceoff and gets the ball to DJ Comer as he rushes down the field and scores the game winner, top left in overtime, to give the Hounds a 7-6 victory over Fairfield.
I mean, going into overtime, we had confidence in John that we were going to get the first possession, so we kind of drew up a play to get Davis Butts coming around the wing hard with his speed. So as that was happening, I just saw that they slid, and I just kind of saw, it was like slow motion, the whole right side opened up. So I called it, and I just went.
In overtime, you want to make overtime as short as possible for your team, you know. And so my first initial reaction is always trying to go forward. Once we get out, once I pick up the ground ball, I know just to get it to Hawk as soon as possible because, you know, the ball on his stick, we can't really go that wrong.
That was It's another one that makes your heart pump pretty quickly on the sidelines. The guys dug in and they played longer than 60 minutes today. I thought that, you know, we really fought hard off the ground. You know, we don't have the resume right now, you know, for an AQ. We have opportunities in front of us, but right now we have to take care of conference. And that's something that we're going to continue to talk about and address. So it means an awful lot.
The Greyhounds travel to D.C. next weekend to take on Georgetown for non-conference play. For all of your Loyola Greyhound athletic information, log on to www.loyolagreyhounds.com.